morning, guys, and welcome back to Crypt Zone. So before we start, please remember to hit that subscribe button if you enjoy my content. And also, if you would like to support me, please follow me on Patreon. You'll find my webpage there. It's only going to cost you 14 Rand or $1, and then I can hopefully improve my content and improve my equipment. Well, we're back for part 2 of Hellblade, and we're going to fight the next god. I always like, you know, looking around the areas first, get a feel for where I am. And also, I'm one of those guys who like to stop in a game and look at the detail. Look at the effort that was put into the game. I also like to just walk through the area and basically work it out for myself, so that if something happens, I will know where to go.
Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the All-Father.
I must say, hearing the North mythology like this is quite interesting. I'm finding out some things I really didn't know. Like Avengers, you know a bit about Thor and the way the Avengers go, and they also talk about Niflheim and all the Nine Realms. But, and you know, in the movie, Hela was Odin's daughter, but here he say that Hela was Loki's daughter, so who's right and who's wrong?
Hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
One thing about this game that I really love is listen to the voices. They give you pretty good advice. I think another thing that I like about this game, or maybe sometimes irritates me, is that there wasn't any tutorial. Nobody taught you how to fight. I had to figure out the fighting for myself as I was fighting. I only found out how to dodge in this second chapter.
Did it.
Well, that's interesting. Did you guys see the difference?
Behind the veil, don't we? Once we do, we mostly just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there. Seeing things differently. Because once you gaze into the relentless darkness, all that lurks within it can see you too.
Here we go again.
He's down. Finish him. Strike him. He won it.
Blocking the strikes at the right time, as you can see, knocks them down or puts them off guard, and that actually helps a lot. Focusing, good thing, it actually makes your attacks faster and more accurate, it's like bullet time, and of course giving the heavy hits takes too much time for me, so I'd rather stick to the quick and, you know, quick medium hits.
Behind you! Behind you!
Northmen will not stop her. She will find what she's looking for.
Valravn's power of illusion comes from ravens, allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Truth.
Look over. Look how much it's changed. It's all different.
For the most part now, I'm just wandering around in the areas looking for the way to get to the top to align the ravens to open the gate.
To break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravn.
So I'm just checking out all the possibilities. I know I have to get to the top. I should have actually just looked at the gate from the beginning. That's why sometimes stuff are shining for a reason. And there we are. Just missed it. Look at that. The wall is open.
Into another world that looks the same but feels different. An imposter world where the forest itself is watching.
To break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravan.
Which ravens? Can't you see them? She comes. Line up your ravens.
This is really helpful. Following his song, wherever you can hear him singing or the direction he's singing from, follow that direction. He actually guides you through the stage.
Valravan, challenge me.
Last winter, before the tragedy, she journeyed into the wilds of her native land, living off berries, roots, and rabbits. It's not uncommon, you see. We call such a person a gelt. Some, like Truth, become gelt in search of penance. Others, like Senua, to purge a curse. Those who make it back are forever changed.
If you're wondering why I'm opening up the doors, I just like to open up locked doors because you never know in the future when you're going to need them. And then you have to all backtrack all the way back to open them when you could have opened them from the beginning. See, the steps are back, or the steps have suddenly appeared once I looked through the gate.
Dark magic. A trick. Valravan is tricking her.
Valravan.
How can she get out?
Bait.
It's him.
Dark magic draws her closer.
Valravan's magic. It's not him. He's helping her.
It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it on her own. He's not tricking her.
It's magic.
It's an illusion.
Excellent. Let's go open up the door.
Just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
At least here I quickly learned how to dodge this guy. This was a bit of a tough fight for me, but at least I got through.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of man was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
So now I'm just going to go through this whole area again. You see me walking around, just checking out the lay of the land, so to say, before we start activating the door and seeing what we have to do.
The song. Oh, Raven. Oh, Raven's song. It's over here. It's over there.
He's there.
Listen, focus, listen. It's magic. This reminds her of somewhere.
The forest.
Where? Which forest?
The forest in the wilds.
The wilds.
And she left it in.
She went to the wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth,
she'd be dead. She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian.
She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian.
But she didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
I'm just trying to follow this guy now to see how to get through, but as you see, there's two of them. So obviously the last one would be the correct one. So I'm just looking around the area, trying to follow path to get to him, and see how we can open up the stage.
Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated a sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry, and gathered them in his mind and learnt them. Then he fell from the tree.
gone.
Since they've gone.
No. Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
Some are still there.
But where?
Raven's helping.
He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet.
It's a trick. I can't think.
Out in the wilds. In the cold winter woods.
Where have they gone?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. She remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her.
Gate is open!
Open!
There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill him. Yet, it will gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillian? Before her time comes.
Well, at last you opened up this gate after looking around all over the place. So, let's go through and see what's waiting on the other side. I was sure there's a boss battle coming now, because this looks like the ideal spot for a boss battle.
Overcome Valravan's final illusion to face him in his keep. I know you can do it, Sinua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together.
Speak to me, Drew. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findon. The Northmen captured Findon's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findon made his escape. What was Findon? Burnt away that day. But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth, the man that I am now. And though Findon never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
Thank you.
gate is open.
It's not open.
It's darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me.
Didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in, it strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom, drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back.
Help me.
But there, in the darkness,
Senua.
And she remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua. Take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus! Focus! Focus!
I see you! I see you now! You led me to the wilds! You trapped me there!
Here we go. The fight. Typical boss, nah, calling out his minions to try and soften you up for him. I'm starting to see a pattern here now, in the way that he's fighting. To win this match, you have to actually block his sickles. Block them and throw them back to him. That's the only way to kill him. Bring it on.
Finish this.
close. Behind you. He's gone.
Yes, then what?
Valravn, one of the keys to the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for Druth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul.
I'm coming. I still hear you.
Badass. Okay, let's quickly run back to the end of this chapter.
When she was younger, she would lay in the grass. Stare at the clouds. And there she saw them. Elusive. Shifting faces. After a while, she could see the faces everywhere. In the trees. The mountains. Caves.
Senua, you have the sight, just like I do. Once you can see into the underworld and all the souls within it will see you. Don't be afraid when they speak to you. I will always be here to guide you.
Did you see her? That was her mother, Galina. She was a priestess, a healer. She taught Senua to see the weave that binds the world together. And it was beautiful. It was a time before the darkness. But when it did come, it first came for her mother. Senua still sees her face from time to time, hidden in the world. Like she's still watching over. She misses her so much.
Oh.
desert, you may cross the bridge over the River of Knives to Hellheim.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for watching. And please come back for part 3 when we actually open up the door and see what's on the other side. Have a great day, guys. Cheers.